crazy podcast about DC with your host E-Rock and PD. When we speak up, get your geeks up, cause you know you about to get geeked up. So sit back, relax, and get comfy. Lose your mind like Solomon Grundy and listen to a show that won't be forgotten. Coming straight out of Gotham.
And hello, everybody out in the world of internet fandom, fanboy nation, nerds across the world, geeks across America, international, fanboys, everybody, welcome to another episode of Straight Outta Gotham. This is lucky number episode 13, Dan Marino, the A-Rod. I ran out of 13s. I can't think of anything else. Those are the top two that came to mind. Jason Voorhees. We are proud members of the Batman Podcast Network, hosted by Batman on Film. I am your co-host from the Garden State. I am Peter M. Vera, and today we are recording on September 1st, 2020. Man, has that flown by. And as always, we have a great show for you today. But before I get into the good stuff, I want to remind all our faithful listeners, if you take the time to review our show and read our show on iTunes, we will read the review and we will send you a special surprise giveaway. We have our winner for August, and we will introduce that person at the end of the show. And you will reach out to us at our Straight Outta Gotham Gmail account, and we will send you our special free giveaway. So please rate and review the show on iTunes so you can get some cool free stuff. Now, I want to introduce to you my co-host, the only man to scale and hang glide from the top of Mount Sinai, Mr. Eric Holzman.
Hello. Oh, wow. I don't know how I can, oh man, how do I quantify that? That's, wow.
All the people out on the island are going to appreciate that one.
You know something? I don't even know if Mount Sinai is an actual mount. to be honest with you, but I did hang glide from it. I did. That's all we know.
The top
from the top of it, maybe just the hospital. Not Sinai, just the hospital. Came right down from there. Whew, it was fun. You know me. I think I might have scared some old people, and in the hospital, I don't know. But yes, it's another thing I've added to my long list of things I've done this summer that Pete has so graciously tracked for me. So hopefully I get a
champion. Huh? The champion.
Yes. Hopefully I get a segment on Dateline or something like that. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Yeah. But yes, Pete, thank you for that great introduction. It's good to be back here with you again to discuss a bunch of news that happened in the past few weeks. First, we should probably highlight very quickly before I go into other news, the Iceberg Lounge show we did on FanDome. So just really quickly, we were together, we partnered with Justin Kowalski from Let's Go, and then Nick, Zednik and Nico Caruso from the Vigilantes 1939 podcast to bring everyone together to do this show. And I thought it went well. I had a really good time. I hope everyone out there who watched it enjoyed it, because we plan on doing this once or twice a month as a live segment and to just bring other podcasters together with us. Pete and I might not be on every show. It could be Justin with a group or another people with a group. Brian Lauer also, he might want to do something with an Iceberg Lounge with other people. So I just want to give a shout out to all you guys and Ryan Lauer as well, man. The clips, his investigative research was was incredible. So yeah, I just wanted to, again, do a quick drop on that. Thanks again to BJ and Nick from After Hours Media for producing the segment. It was great.
Do it without them.
Yeah, we could not have done that without them, that's for sure. So just really quick housekeeping off the top. So let's just flow into the news now. And first, we did discuss this on the Iceberg Lounge, but I will bring it up again on our show, is the passing of Bllack Panther star Chadwick Boseman from colon cancer. And 43 years old, same age as me. So, you know, when it hits a little harder for me as well because of that. And plus, as Pete knows, and I don't know if the rest of you know, but one of my good friends passed from colon cancer within the past 2 years. And he was the same age as me. So this is another bit of information like that. Without going too far into the personal side of things with it, obviously we know him through his work. Like, we don't know him personally, but we know him through his work. And whether it was Bllack Panther, he played a bunch of characters, Jackie Robinson, Thurgood Marshall, James Brown. Like, he played all these iconic characters, and such a talent, and he's going to be missed. So, Pete, just a few moments on Boseman.
Yeah, I'm still new to Boseman. Like, I mean, 42 and Bllack Panther are the movies that always come to mind for me. But I've been doing a lot of research and just he was on like Days of Our Lives and just where he came from and how he left that role. And then Michael B. Jordan actually filled in for him. So they've always kind of been intertwined. But I mean, just a hell of a catalog to look through. He made an impact in a short period of time. It was crazy how he passed. I believe it was, or was it announced that he passed on Jackie Robinson Day for Major League, which also ended up being Jack Kirby's birthday, who is the creator of Bllack Panther and so many other fantastic, amazing comic book characters that we all love. So it was almost like full circle, you know, and just really crazy stuff. Just so young. Cancer is a horrible thing. And I just, my thoughts and prayers go out to his family and his loved ones and his friends, because it seems like he was a great man, and it's a shame we lost one like that.
Yeah, I concur with everything you said. You know, again, he's 43 years old, and he had so much left to give, not just as an actor, but as you said, was humanitarian. He visited children children suffering with cancer at the hospital while he also had it, and I mean, that had to be rough. There are a couple of clips of him talking about that out there when he was doing press tour for Bllack Panther, him talking about visiting the hospitals with the kids. And he broke down a few times. And you can, now looking back at it, you understand it was much deeper, obviously, for him. But the fact he could be suffering through this for 4 years, film Bllack Panther while he had cancer, which is a pretty physically demanding role. I know they use CGI for some stuff, but I'm sure he did some of it on his own.
It's just not easy to move in that suit, you know?
Yeah. And, you know, the fact that he did all of this, man, and kept it a secret, that's the crazy part. In a day and age where nothing is secret, if you're someone in Hollywood, for him to keep this a secret and be able to do it successfully, that's incredible. So, like, even when you just think about that as a person and as a performer, man, he really gave it his all. He never used his disease as an excuse, and he very well could have. So,
yeah, it's just a shame. Gone too soon, really.
Yeah, definitely gone too soon. So rest in peace, Bllack Panther. May you rule in Necropolis as you did here on Earth. So moving on. Moving on to a more happier, positive note. As we discussed earlier, we did a show on DC FanDome Day 1, and DC FanDome Day Part 2 is coming up on September 12th, which was more of the television and seems television comic and specific comic book angle show, looking at the schedule anyway. So they're giving some like classes, there's some worldwide panels from all over the place, and they're discussing obviously all the TV shows. So the CW, the Arrowverse, all of those shows, Harley Quinn will be on it. Batwoman, obviously. Black Lightning, Doom Patrol. So we're having all of these, the separation of the TV stuff and the movie stuff, obviously we saw on day one, and the TV stuff now we're getting on day two. So there's also other parts of it that they're going to have for day two. So you have all the other verses, you have the Insiderverse, you have the U-verse. All the other things that we have that they have on the listed on the page, the DC FanDome page. So if you guys are looking forward to it, go to DCFandom.com. You can check out all of that there. So Pete, what is your anticipation for day two? And is there any panel you're looking forward to?
Man, coming off a day. First of all, expect another Iceberg Lounge for FanDome Part Two. Like, let's just,
yes,
we're gonna cover this extensively just because we had so much fun doing FanDome Part One, and I believe this show this time we're going to actually be live after FanDome, so it'll be literally post game. But like, I'm just pumped. I mean, right off the bat, just looking at the schedule, first of all, Batman Joker War panel, I'm sure James Tynan will be there. Really looking forward to hear what he has to say, because we'll get into it later. But Joker War was built up as like the big event of the summer. Three Jokers panel also. Maybe Jeff Johns will be there. Maybe, what's his name?
Fabok.
It's not Fabok. Was it Fabok? He actually pronounces it something. Fabok. I was trying to do it, and I totally just brain farted here. Fabok. Jason Fabok.
Okay, Fabok. Right.
Pronounces it. Yeah, I was like, wait, how do I do this? I would love to hear them, because one issue, and we're going to get into this later. We got a whole segment show. Wow. I mean, three Jokers. Wow. Yes. The life and art of Jim Lee. The last one was really great. I can't wait to see what he does this time. The death of the family, the game panel. Really interested to see what more they show us, because, you know, like Gotham Knights really left more for more. It's big shoes to step in, because there's so much game footage, you know, like desired now that like, I'm like, oh man, like show me. I'm sorry. I said game panel, movie panel was like, you show me all this stuff for this video game, and that's supposed to be interactive, but the death in the family movie, like I want to see how interactive this movie actually is. You know, I got confused. I had my notes, but yeah, like I'm like, what, I want to see what an interactive movie is. That's so interesting to me. Like this is so fresh and it's so new. Like I'm so interested to see what that's like. Then Doom Patrol panel and the extended Flash panel, because I just finished season 6 of Flash. And let me tell you, really great. I think probably one of the better seasons they've done. I'd say it's up there within the top 3 of seasons for me personally. And what they do at Mirror Master, brilliant. I love every second of it. So I'm really excited for season 7 of The Flash. So that's what I'm pumped for.
So yeah, I haven't.
And there's tons of stuff, you know? Like
what?
There's so much more stuff in here. Like
I
barely cracked it. Like, you know, Black Lightning, everything. But Eric, like, what are you pumped for?
Well, a lot of the ones you mentioned as well, obviously the Three Jokers panel, because as you said, the first issue was so great. So I'm really looking forward to that panel. I'm looking forward to get the Death in the Family panel as well. I'm interested to see what that's all about. Having some kind of choose your own adventure type movie, I think could be a lot of fun. So I want to see how they came about that. I'm also looking at the Deathstroke Knights of Dragons animated movie that's coming out. That looks pretty interesting to me. It's one of those animated films that you're kind of like, oh, okay, let's see what they're going to do with it. So, and I love the character. So I'm hoping we get a little bit of revealing of revelations from that panel. Harley Quinn. I finally almost caught up, Pete. You'll be happy to hear that. I'm almost actually caught up.
How much are you loving it? How much are you loving
it? It's great. It is a great, great show. Apologize
to me for being late.
I will apologize to you. But it's really excellent, and it's funny, it's goofy, it pokes fun at the characters, and it just all works. Everyone who does the voice work is incredible. So I really, really enjoy it. So I'll be looking forward to any Harley Quinn information I could get. And those are the things I'm focused. Obviously, Doom Patrol. I love the show. So whatever they can say.
Just scrolling through, there's another panel I just saw that really interests me. Mostly Deceased. I think Tom Taylor's Deceased Elseworlds books have been really fantastic. And it's a nice breath of fresh air in terms of comic books when you don't have to worry about continuity and stuff. And I would love to see what he has to bring to the table. I'd love to see what that panel is about. Hopefully he's there. But if you're not reading that, Eric, man, I can't. Those are some really interesting stories. Everyone's dying. You can't figure it out. Like every time you fall in love with a character, they die the next. It's nuts. I love.
So you're constantly disappointed.
I'm disappointed, but I'm such the shock and all. And Tom Taylor's right now at the top of his game. Writing wise, I mean, he's just writing really heartfelt stories about people and survival and just, you know, just standing together and banding together as a group and putting your differences aside. It's really good. Like Eric, like go buy the trade, or it's probably on DC Universe, but read the start with Deceased and just move on. And they're so good. They're so good.
Okay.
What he did with Mr. Miracle and Barda. Oh my God. I was like, wow, that was insane. That was great. So yeah, right. Highly recommended.
I take your word for it. I will dive deep into that and see if I can confirm what you're saying or if I agree with it. There's a lot of Superman stuff that's going to be on day 2 as well. So if you're a Superman fan, I think you guys want to pay attention to that.
Superman and Lois, yep. Enduring the Symbol of Hope, yep. The Man of Tomorrow panel. Yeah, I mean, that's everything just since 1 o'clock. Like, they don't have like the actual schedule up, but I guess it's in its order.
Yeah, I'm assuming it's in its order. They have extended panels as well for Titans, so I'll probably check that out because I love that show. So I will probably check
now,
that out.
What I will pay attention to, just because I'm so interested, because I haven't been reading this, is take a tour of DC's death metal metalverse.
Yeah, I saw that too.
I'm not the biggest. I love Scott Snyder's New 52 stuff. I love his American Vampire. I love the Black Mirror. But everything, I want to say, like, I didn't read New Justice, whatever that story was. Mm-hmm. I didn't like metal. I think the Batman Who Laughs is highly overused. So, like, but I'm interested to see it because everyone else tells me how much they love it. So I want to see this like little mini documentary or whatever they have to show just to see what I'm missing. So I'm interested in it because I stopped paying attention to it. And I wonder if it's something I should pick back up. So right. I'm willing to give this a shot, but it just strikes my interest. I'm like, okay, well, I don't have to spend money reading this, but tell me about it. You know?
Well, anyone who has listened to you here or anywhere else or follows you on Twitter, you're pretty much a purist. So, and that line is very, very different.
am I a purist? I don't know.
In a lot of ways, you are. In a lot of ways, you are.
Realizing me. So.
It's not a bad thing. It's not a bad thing to be a purist. You know, you have your takes on things that are you know, it's traditional, and I think with these characters, so, and that's fine. But you give things a chance. I will say that you do give things a chance. So you're not narrow-minded. You have an affinity for.
I'm just for thick-headed.
The pure. Well, yeah, that, you can say that too. I guess we can throw that out there.
You know, let's not just dance around this here. You're just kind of, you know, arrogant and stubborn and thick-headed. Yeah.
So also this I saw this villains panel, and it looks like they're bringing back a bunch of supervillains from all different types of DC what's the word I'm looking for? I can't think today. All different kinds of DC movies and animation, and they're bringing a bunch of voices back and some people who played the part. Cool. Yeah, and the villain, and it's all supervillains based. So like Tara Strong.
I love Tara Strong.
Yes. Gina Gershon.
Great.
Yeah, Diedrich Bader. So all these people who have, you know.
Dude, Ziggy Marley's doing a live performance. I can't believe that.
I think people may like that better than Chris Daughtry. I don't know. But
I didn't watch Daughtry, but I will watch Ziggy Marley.
Yeah, so. And of course, as you said, the Three Jokers panel, again, is one I think we'll both be looking for. And we can now actually talk a little bit about the first issue of Three Jokers. So,
wow.
I don't know if I want to do spoiler stuff, but if you do, just say spoiler and then we can go forward.
I'm not going to talk too many spoilers. I mean, nothing that you don't already know, but I mean, just right. Here's the thing. Johns and I forgot his name again.
Fabic,
thank you. Sorry, David. Johns and Fabic are two of the top tier, you know, upper echelon artists, writers, respectively.
Yes.
And it's just to have them both on a book and then to open the book and it feels almost Killing Joke-ish, the artwork, you know, mm-hmm. But it's got that signature trademark that Jason has, Fabic. See, I tried to avoid his last name there because I forgot it again. But it's just great. And then to combine the whole premise of the story is so interesting. It's like, okay, so there's more than one Joker now, but mm-hmm. the heroes of the story are Batman, the Red Hood, mm-hmm. and Batgirl, Barbara Gordon. Those are the three probably most tormented people in the history of the Joker. So it's kind of celebrating all the big, you know, the big events, the crippling of Barbara Gordon. And, you know, depending on who you talk to, whether or not she was raped, and then, you know, the murder of Jason Todd, and, you know, just, wow, just I'm surprised no one else has decided to tackle this before, but I'm glad that it's Johns and,
yes,
Jason. So it's fantastic. And it's, you're flipping through and you're like, man, like I got to look at this page because it's so beautiful. You know, the artwork is gorgeous, and I forget who the colorist is. I don't have the book in front of me. I mean, everything about the book is just A-list. It's a beautiful, stunning book. It's written wonderfully. It looks gorgeous.
I bought
all five variant covers. I didn't know they were going to do that for all the issues. I was like, oh, man, I can't spend all this kind of money. You guys are crazy. But the variant covers look great. I couldn't be pleased. And it's funny because I told Eric, you know, off air, that Joker War was built up with James Tynion as the Bat Joker Revenge of the Summer. And it's almost over. And one issue into it, three Jokers has made every, and Reno loves Joker War. Like, he's absolutely loving Joker War. And I think it's good too. It's not the greatest. It's not the worst. It's a good Batman Joker story, but three Jokers just looks like it's on a different level.
Yeah, I agree. I agree with everything you said. The artwork is beautiful. The story is crafted so well, and it's kind of a psychological type of, you know, look into the characters, right? You get the three characters, and then of course that you mentioned, the good guys, Batman, Barbara, and Jason Todd, and then the three Jokers as well, because there's hints in the book that the three Jokers could be people we know already. I'll just leave it there, like that. So. Everything about it, I love. Normally with some comic books, I can pause and not want to finish it. But this one, when I started reading it, I was just like, it was a page turner. I'm like, okay, I have to keep going. The way it begins, just perfect. It sets it up so well, sets up the book so well. So yeah, guys, if you haven't read it yet, definitely go out and get it and read it. But I'm now so interested in where we're going with this, right? Like, it leaves you at a point where you're kind of like, okay, let's go.
I love Geoff Johns' writing. I really do. I mean, like, my favorite piece of his is the Sinestro Corps War, like that whole tie-in when he was doing Green Lantern back in the beginning. But I mean. His Batman Earth One's great, and this just looks like another great addition to Geoff Johns' bibliography.
Yeah, he's a very, very, very good writer. Like, he understands, I think, the characters very well, and he knows what people want to read about them, and then he just writes from that point of view. Mm-hmm. And it's really, really a really, really good book for a first entry. Like, the first entry, obviously, in anything like this always has to be very good because you want people to come back. And again, like I said, I can't wait for issue two now, the second book. So I'm amped. I'm ready.
I can't remember the last time a comic book has kind of one issue in just kind of really created such positive vibe. You know, like when this book came out on Tuesday, and then, you know, depending on, DC releases their books on Tuesday and everybody else does Wednesday because of Diamond, and they have different distributors now. But, you know, once everyone's, depending on what day you go to pick up your books, because Rob Myers only picks up DC books. You won't catch him on a Wednesday. It's Marvel Day. So, like, whenever you go to pick up your books, like, everyone by Wednesday was talking about this book.
Yeah, they were.
It doesn't really happen often. I can't remember the last time. It has to be really early in the Ewing Immortal Hulk run. And where it was maybe about like the 10th issue. So that's, I think that's well over a year ago. But but it was nice. It was just like, wow, like people, especially because it's Batman. You know, like Hulk's having great issues. It's really, well, that's wonderful. Like, I'm pumped for the Hulk. I can't wait to read it. But to have it as Batman, you know, it's like, oh, wow, this is great. And Batman and the Joker, it's like really, really, it's right in my wheelhouse.
Yeah. I mean, we've had a lot of good Batman, obviously, content, right? Recently, it's been, you know, whether it's on screen in a video game, you know, now this book as well, it's really, really good. And there's one page I want to talk about, and I won't say what it is, but how can I phrase this without giving it away? Okay, it's kind of a goofy page. There's something going on in it it's funny that they'd include it in here, that they would, but the fact that he went to this detail to show it, all the hint I'll give you is it's truck driving. And let's see if you remember, if you think you're on the page that I'm thinking of.
We got to talk about this all there because I have no idea what he's talking about. He never talked about before. Like, I'm just like, what? And it's like, my mom box isn't within arm's distance. Like, it's on the other side of the room. So it's not like I can sneak out to be like, wait, what were you talking about, Eric? Like, it's like, I'm not getting up. I'll just wait till after the show. But
it's just one of those things that you're reading anything. It could be any kind of book. And then you get a page and you're like, that's an interesting page. But when you continue, it fits. So we'll talk about it off air. But yeah, there's this one page in here that I'm kind of like, wow, I love it. Just for the detail it gives to the rest of the story. So again, guys, three Jokers. Pete and I both love it, right? So two thumbs up from us.
Head to your local comic shop, pick up this book. You won't regret it. If it's the only comic, if there's one comic book to buy from last week, it's Three Jokers.
Yes, and I ordered it, but it didn't come in time. But I got the digital copy, so
there are no comic shops on the island.
No, there are. There are. I just didn't go. I ordered it. There's like two or three not far from where I live. I'm an idiot. I can just say that. But maybe I'll go see and grab a copy.
Support mom and pop. I'll tell you.
No, I do. I do. Normally I would. But I just did that for this one. And I did. And I ordered the when it's going to be made, obviously, into the graphic novel in November. So I'll be getting that when they're all done.
I'll get the hardcover. For something like that, I'll get a hardcover. If it ends as good as it started, I'll hold out for the absolute edition, you know, aka or Ryan Lauer spelled like lower.
Shout out to Ryan again. Batman. Of course. Batman Book Club, part of the family. We support all of our brothers, podcasting brothers. Yes. Shout out to Ryan Lauer.
Follow Bat Pod Network on Twitter at Bat Pod Network for all these wonderful podcasts that you love, including Straight Outta Gotham.
Yes.
Batman Book Club.
First. No, I'm kidding. Whichever one you like. Go ahead.
I'm trying to think of everybody on the network.
Okay, Pete, go ahead. Read about.
I don't have the list. This is just on the top of my head. I'm sorry. I got Chris Carver. I feel good enough.
All right. So,
what? I'm just interrupting you.
Of course. It's okay. It's all love. Anyway, so as we mentioned, we've had a lot of Batman news being released recently. We talked, obviously the Batman trailer that we talked about on the Iceberg Lounge. We won't discuss that too much. Maybe a little bit later. We'll have a little bit of a conversation about it. Obviously, we've got the release of Three Jokers, which we both love. And now we got news that they will be doing an animated version of The Long Halloween. It's going to be a two-parter to be released in 2021. And hold on a second. It's going to be produced by Bruce Timm. And the voice cast includes Grimm's David Giannatoli as the voice of Batman, Arrow's Michael Jai White as Bronze Tiger, Mark Dacascos as Richard Dragon, Helly Hugh as Lady Shiva, James Hong as Osensei, and Josh Keaton as Jeffrey Burr. So that's the lineup for the voice cast that we have so far. So, Pete, I've actually discussed this book on the Batman Book Club with Ryan Lauer. My very first appearance on it was discussing The Long Halloween. So I don't want to go too in-depth into actually the book, but it's going to be a two-parter. So I know I'm anticipating this because it's one of my favorites. What about you?
Oh, I'm highly anticipating this. The Long Halloween, I own two DC Absolute Editions. One is the Sinestro Corps War that we mentioned earlier, and the other one is the Long Halloween, and I love the Long Halloween. I love the influence it had on Dark Knight, and I can't wait to see this film finally get its due, just because it's such an ensemble. It's got all the big names in Gotham. Everyone's in this story, and it's so much fun and just intertwined and mysterious, and I even love its sequel, Dark Victory, and the Halloween Tales. Those are great too. So Loeb and Tim Sale have really left an impact on me when it comes to my Batman, just like preferences, you know, the detective, the gothic figure. So I'm wondering how they're going to translate this. Some of these movies are like let's say Batman, Superman, Apocalypse. They made that movie to look like it was illustrated by Michael Turner, the late great Michael Turner. A movie like Batman Hush didn't look anything like Jim Lee. I'm wondering because Tim Sale's artwork has such a distinct look, you know, his Batman is barrel chested and big and monstrous, while his Joker has this like pointy chin and pointy nose and this really extravagant smile, and his Catwoman with these ears. It's so interesting, Tim Sale's artwork. So I wonder what, and he draws a beautiful Solomon Grundy. So it's, I wonder what they're going to do. But my only complaint is I don't like the whole, like, we're going to make it into two parts. I didn't like it about Dark Knight Returns, but I waited because they announced this when they were going to, when the movie was announced, that they were going to eventually put it all together as one movie. And that's when I ended up buying my physical copy. So I waited until it was one, so I could watch it in one setting, you know? And that's kind of how I felt about the Snyder Cut too. I was like, oh, don't give me four parts. I want one whole thing. You know, like, I want it now. I've been waiting. Yeah, like, I'll see how long I can hold out, because this story means so much to me. Hopefully I can hold out this way. I don't end up buying three different versions, part one, part two, and then part one and part two, you know? So, I'll try to hold out, but I'm pumped. I do kind of wish that Conroy was voicing Batman and Hamill was voicing the Joker, because of how special Long Halloween is to me. But I will trust the creatives. Outside of Batman and Harley Quinn, Bruce Timm has never steered me wrong, and I do not hate what he did with The Killing Joke. So I trust him as well, and I'm looking forward to – I just can't wait. This is one of my favorite all-time Batman stories. It's just so exciting, and I'm so happy that it is going to be – the best part about it being in two parts is they're not going to cram everything in a small time frame. So this story will have time to breathe and explain everything, and I can't wait. I'm pumped. It's very exciting.
All right, I actually need to correct myself. I read the voice list of Batman Soul of the Dragon, which is coming out.
You did that. I was like, this isn't right. But
it's okay. You can correct me. You can stop me. It's all right. But yes, I will apologize. So Batman Soul of the Dragon, that movie that's coming out, that's the voice cast I read. The voice cast for The Long Halloween has not yet been named. So it's just been announced that they're actually doing the movie. And yeah, I'm with you, man. This is one of my favorite books, and it's a story that has impacted so many other parts, things that we've heard, obviously The Dark Knight. You know, so it's a Batman story that's very rich. It has a lot of layers to it, and the fact that we're getting a direct adaptation, because I remember on the show with Lauer on the Batman Book Club, I did say to him, do you think this would be a good, you know, straight as a live action movie? Of course it probably would be, but the fact we're getting it as a animated film, that's as close enough for me. I think that's close as we're going to get. So I'm really looking forward to it. And yeah, maybe they will bring Conroy and Hamill in to do it. So,
hey Eric, look, don't feel bad. I compared Death in a Family to a video game earlier in the show. So we're just,
if you forget, it's quite all right. Oh, hey, hey, make mistakes. It's fine. It's cool. I'm human. I was reading the article and I skipped over the part for the actual
all the little trolls on the idiot to a video. Oh god, brain, these guys are so stupid. I don't know why they have a podcast.
Well, I think it would have been stupid for me to not correct myself. So the fact that I saw the error and I did correct myself, I think I should get some props for that. But anyway, so yes, Long Halloween, animated, coming out 2021, two parts. Look for it, guys. I know this is a book that so many people love, so I'm sure it's going to have a really, really good response. I hope they stick mostly to the source material. We did have changes in Hush, obviously, and they do take liberties sometimes.
I kind of dug it. I dug it.
Yeah, I was fine with that. But I'm saying, you know, as we talked about purists before, there are certain people who are going to be like, why'd you do that? It was fine the way it was.
I love Hush. I got an absolute edition. I got a regular trade paperback. I bought it twice in issue format, you know, like, I love this story, so I cannot wait for this. This is so awesome. I can't wait.
Yeah, so do you, just really quickly, Soul of the Dragon, is that a story you're familiar with?
No, it's the first time I'm hearing of it too, actually. Breaking news. Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, so it's that looks pretty cool too. Now that I think about it.
No, yes, I do remember this. This is a Sam Liu directed movie. It's going to take place in the 70s. The Yellow Oval is returning in this animated film. That is very true. I did hear about this. Yes, I did.
Okay.
It was a
fandom. There's another announcement. Let's look out for that one too. I love all the I really mostly love most of the animated movies. So,
you know, honestly, I did. The only one I don't like is Batman and Harley Quinn.
Well, yeah, but I didn't like the
deep. I think Superman Unbound is fantastic. I really do. That might be the one I might watch the most. It's so good. It's a Superman Brainiac Supergirl story. Really fantastic. I love that story. And Green Lantern Emerald Knights, because I love the story of Bofonga the Unrelenting.
Okay. There you go, guys. You have two more titles now. Pete just named. If you haven't seen them, give them a watch. And then if you don't like them, complain to Pete.
Rowdy Roddy Piper, if I'm not mistaken, voices Bofonga.
So, oh, all right.
So for you wrestling fans, that's how I'm going to trick you into watching this. Rowdy Roddy Piper is the voice of Bofonga the Unrelenting. I believe that's true.
All right. So we mentioned the Batman trailer before, and obviously we've talked about it ad nauseum. We talked about it on the Iceberg Lounge with the Vigilantes and with Justin from Let's Go. So just really quickly from both of us, to sum it up, we love it. You know, that's pretty much the easiest way to say it. We can't wait. I was on the fence, as you know, about the film, and now I'm totally over on the positive side. I'm in the yard and I'm ready to watch.
I feel long enough, dude.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I liked little things about it. I didn't love the Batmobile when I first saw it. And there were
saw it in motion.
Yeah, I liked, but I always liked the suit. I was one of the people who liked the suit. I thought it was good. I did like also in the trailer, you see him take a gunshot off and it kind of like gets, I don't know, lights up a little bit, or I don't know if that's just a deflection from the bullet, but.
A yellow oval, you mean?
Yeah, a little bit of it creates a yellow oval when you hit it. So yeah, so Pete and I obviously have watched it many times, and I probably haven't watched it as much as you. I'll give you that. The night it was released, I watched it many, many times, but since then it's been less. I did put it on 4K because it was on 4K on YouTube, so I watched it on the TV, and that was incredible as well in 4K. Really, really nice. So yeah, so but Pete, do you currently know what the count is for the teaser? What the viewing count is that?
Personally, my count is about, like, I don't know, 500. if we're just going to go there. But let's see here. If I go to YouTube, it'll tell me right away. And we are currently at, we are over 20 million views on YouTube.
Wow.
That's the Warner Brothers count.
That is insane.
Today's the only day, September 1st. As of 2:21 p.m., I have not watched it. It's the first day. As of yet, I haven't watched the trailer yet. It's the first time that's happened. So right. I will watch it. I will not go without watching it. There will not be a day that goes by that I do not watch it until this movie comes out. This could be the only thing they release, and I will watch it every day. Like, it is the greatest 2.5 minutes of my life. I love it.
That's a mouthful right there. That is a mouthful.
Well, can't do anything because it's a pandemic, so.
But no, I agree, man. Like, every day, if I'm just sitting around, I get a boring point of the day, I'll just watch it. It is one of those things that you just keep going back to, because I feel like every time I watch it, I see something else that I missed, or, you know, like, you watch it again, you're like, oh crap, or you see something and then your mind starts going another place, like, well, maybe they're going here with it, maybe this is what that means. And again, there are a few titles in my life that could do that to me. Star Wars is probably number one, but then next is Batman. Right underneath Star Wars would be anything Batman that would keep bringing me back to just keep watching it. So, yeah, that count over 20 million, yeah. That's insane, man. That is an insane number. That just shows you that the anticipation for this film.
Solo Batman creates a buzz like no other comic book movie known to man.
And it had, like, I had done, as you know, I had done a report saying that people weren't that interested in it and weren't really waiting for it to come. But obviously, as the trailer has done with me, it has converted many more people over to want it, to anticipate this film. And then just to go back, how much Batman we're going to be getting next year. Very cool. Whether it's really in animation or obviously the Snyder Cut, and then we have the Batman. Hopefully all the dates remain, because as we know with the pandemic, things could shift. So, but hopefully all the dates remain and we are getting all this Batman content, which for us will be great. And for people like us will be great. So very lastly, I wanted to bring up that the Batman Day has been announced, right?
Yeah, Batman Day is official. It is happening this month, September 19th. So it's after FanDome Part 2. So that's exciting. So I imagine we'll have some, we'll get some cool information about Batman Day. I'm sure there'll be some cool giveaways or something in terms of, they always give away like maybe a free comic book or something, you know, for
just Batman the merch, Day. Right? Just the discounts on merchandise.
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure there'll be something. I know DC Universe is going to announce something on Batman Day. I'm looking at this Hollywood Reporter article right now. So I'm excited. I mean, Batman Day is always cool. I mean, I'm sure your local comic shops will have sales and stuff, and you could always pick up some back issues, some trades, you know, posters, action figures, all cool stuff. But I'm pumped. I mean, it's a fun little, like, I don't know, made up holiday, I guess. You know, every day is Batman Day for me, but to kind of actually have a designated day is kind of funny.
Yeah, they're doing this thing this year too, where they're on social media where they're going to have a bat signal that lights, and then you can follow his chase of the Riddler.
Really? Is that tying to the movie specifically, or do they just pick the Riddler?
Oh, I don't know if it does. I don't know but you can download it. You have to download an app to your phone, and then you can actually do the track it. So it's a cool little, cute little thing. It's probably more for kids.
Pokemon Go?
Huh? Yeah. No, I don't think we're going to have to get out and find things. I don't think so, anyway.
It'd be awesome if they made a Batman Pokemon Go game, because then it'd be like, oh, find clues.
Yeah, well, maybe it is, because this – hold on. I'll read it. It said, did DC FanDome whet your appetite for even more of The Dark Knight? Enjoy fans all around the world as they celebrate the world's greatest detective. It starts with a week-long celebration full of activities perfect for families and fans of all ages. Join the Caped Crusader on a global Twitter adventure as he pursues the Riddler through Gotham City. Find the clues that unlock wonderful limited-time rewards. Keep checking back here for the latest Batman Day clues and news.
So that's what it is. It is that. That's cool. I'm going to do that. I'm down for that. Let's do it.
So, yeah. So this is all – this again, this all corresponds to Batman Day.
Oh, ooh. Okay. Okay. I want to be the Blue Jay.
Okay.
That's my superhero nickname. I'll have to come up with like a costume that doesn't look like Nightwing, but like, I know Batman likes birds, so if I pick a bird, he'll naturally pick
me. Yeah. So, yeah. Guys, to check out the Batman Day, I'm just letting Pete go off on his own right now. It is mine. That's fine. So, to check out everything about Batman Day, go to dccomics.com/Batman Day, and you can get the early information now. And then it'll obviously update as time goes on, and you can go back and check any new news that they have about it. But yes, it is fun that we are getting a Batman Day. You know, they already do, there's a virtual run also set up, and you can buy gear for the virtual run. I don't know where the virtual run is or when it is. Maybe it is on the 20th.
We should do some kind of hashtag thing. How about like Batman Day Hall? Like, and then you go to your comic book shop, you tweet Straight Out of Gotham, hashtag Batman Day Hall, show us your books that you got, and we can kind of share with everybody and celebrate in our own virtual, socially distanced way. Look at that. I'm bringing everybody.
That's a good idea, guys. This is live planning in our podcast.
So Saturday, September 19th, go to your local comic shop, support them, celebrate Batman Day, pick up some Batman Day, pick up Batman anything. It doesn't have to be comic books. It could be comic books. It could be toys, posters, buttons, wallpaper, anything they sell, toothbrushes. And tweet us at @straight_o_g, hashtag Batman Day Hall, and let's see what you guys come up with. Because
it's the Hershey bar, the chocolate bar that they have with the characters on it, you get one of those, tweet it at us.
I want to see, are you Hershey's with almonds? Are you kind of like, what kind of Hershey bar do you like? I like almonds personally, that's my favorite.
I do too, but I don't think the characters come
on the almonds. Dark chocolate. Oh,
well, I told you guys, I ordered a bunch of them from Hershey, so I have like a 36 pack of all of these characters. I didn't get any Green Lantern, but that's fine. I can buy them.
How do you get 36 and no lanterns?
I don't know. I don't know why they left it out, but for some reason, it's one, I think there's 1 through 7 or 1 through 6 characters on it. And Green Lantern was the one they left out for me. I didn't get any of that one. Anyway, when you open the chocolate bar itself, you actually see each square. You know how Hershey's is set up by squares? You actually see the symbol of one of the characters.
Cool. I'll have to check this out.
So they sell them in miniatures, and then which I had bought originally, and then they sell, obviously, the larger bars as well. So I know we really went off on a tangent to talk about chocolate, but it is DC Batman themed. So, yeah, everything to go along with Batman Day, which actually this year, now that Pete and I have Straight Outta Gotham, we're doing this. We're going to, Pete just mentioned one thing, and we'll brainstorm on some other things that we can bring to you guys maybe for Batman Day to do.
A lot of them will probably happen on air.
Like, just yeah, maybe. Now. Hey, maybe we'll do a live show on Batman Day. Who knows?
Maybe. And we'll, hey, look, this is what I got. This is it. I bought this laser disc of Batman and Robin.
Yeah, who knows? Pete and I are crazy sometimes.
Yeah. So don't forget, September 19th, Batman Day. Any Batman merch you buy on Batman Day, tweet us @straight_O_G, #BatmanDayHall. And we will we'll talk about it, and we'll compare our goodies.
Yep. And again, if we're live that day, we even do it right on the spot. We'll check our Twitter. Look at that.
Yeah. Hey, look. Shout out to like Carlos from the Nerd Room. Shout out to Nico from the Vigilantes. Look what they got. They got this cool Batman pillow. I don't know.
So, again, live planning. You guys look behind the curtain, little behind the scenes action right now with Pete and I as we discuss plans that we never discussed before live on our podcast. So speaking of shouting out, we have a winner for the
champion.
Comment.
Yes, we do. We have our champion of August. And yeah, so Uni VEXM. I don't know how to pronounce your name, Uni Exum. I don't know, but UNIVEXM on iTunes on August 10th, 2020 wrote, "I've been following Batman on film for a few years, and because of that site, I found so many great people and Batman fans. Peter and Eric are great hosts, and I love that they talk everything Batman and DC on this show. I look forward to more and more as we get closer to seeing the new Batman movie. Great stuff, guys." Uni, as I'll offer to you by my nickname, Uni, gave us 5 stars, and he loved our show. So please reach out to us at our Straight Outta Gotham email account so I can get your address and I can mail you your gift because you took the time to write us a beautiful little note on iTunes. So please email us at straightogpodcast@gmail.com. That'll go to me and Eric, and we'll both get your information. I have your gift. It's pretty cool. It's pretty big. I'd say it's the size of a record. Yeah. And I think you'll enjoy it. So, Uni, send us an email, straightogpodcast@gmail.com, and I would love to send you your gift. Hopefully you live within the United States.
Uni, thank you again for the kind words, man. We appreciate it, and that's what we do here. That's what we do. We give back to our fans. Yes,
wherever the postal service will take it, but we're spreading love.
Of course, because we love our fans. You guys show us love, even if you show us hate. If it was a hateful comment, that Pete and I were like, "Hey, it's pretty good."
Look, if you come at us and you're trolling hard, and you came up with this quick, just like little like zinger, and I was like, holy, like I can't believe this guy wrote this. I'll read it on air. You might not get the best surprise, but I'll read it on air. I'll get you something. It won't be nothing. It won't be coal, but I'll get you something.
Yes, I appreciate both the love and the hate, because the hate, that means you're listening. So if you're hate listening, that's fine with me. Just keep coming back. Keep coming back, because that's what we want. We just want people to keep coming, keep listening to us, argue with us, love us, hate us. It's all good for me.
All good. Just remember, Uni won the August giveaway. We will have another giveaway. September is your month of entry, so keep those reviews and likes and comments coming, and we will pick another winner around the week of October 1st.
All right. So I think we're at the end of this journey. I think we've come to the end of this one. So
has the glider run out of air?
Yeah, I'm coming in for a landing right now. Trying to make sure I don't crash into anyone or thing or kill myself.
Please don't do that. I gotta do a show alone.
But Pete, while I'm coming in for a landing, do you have anything to plug?
I do tons of things to plug. Follow me on social media at Pete Illustrated. I would love to talk to you about anything. Batman, why do the Yankees suck? there's so many topics, you know, Mel Kiper's hair, like whatever. I don't care. But read my reviews of Detective Comics on Batman on Film. Follow me and interact with me on social media at Pete Illustrated. Make sure to check out our past two live streams of the Iceberg Lounge at the Straight Outta Gotham YouTube channel. We're trying to expand upon that and do a lot more fun stuff. And just pay attention to the Batpod Network and just listen to all these great shows. Ryan Lauer, Chris Clow, Ryan Haas, Rob Myers, just got a ton of really great guys being creative and just talking about the stuff that we all love. And it's just cool to just, you know, sit back and it's easy listening. So enjoy that stuff.
Yes. Thank you, Pete. And for me as well, if you guys want to interact with me, it's at Final E33. It's spelled Finale 33 on Twitter and Instagram. As Pete mentioned, check out the last two streams of the Iceberg Lounge. We put a lot of work into those, so we're proud of them. And we definitely want to hear your feedback. And we want, whether within the community or you know, just fans of the shows, definitely want all your feedback about that. Look forward to us again on the Iceberg Lounge coming up in a few weeks to do the first. We're going to have a pre-show on September 11th at night where we'll be introducing a new member to the team. Her name is Rachel Robbins, and she will kind of be making drinks for us. So that'll be fun. We'll have that going on there. And also on September 12th, the FanDome Day 2 recap show from the Iceberg Lounge. It will be Pete, myself, Justin Kowalski, and we'll see who else. We're going to try and maybe we beef it up a little bit.
You're editing the guest list.
Huh?
I don't know. We're just editing. We don't have a guest list yet. It's three of us.
It's definitely me, Pete, and Justin. So if you love us, you'll hear us again on the recap show, DC FanDome recap show on September 12th. So for Peter Vera, I am Eric Holzman. This is Straight Outta Gotham. Thank you for listening, and we'll see you next time.
Peace.